Hi, this is Gary with MacMost. Now, on today's episode, let's take a look at some of the more interesting, fun, and useful templates in Pages. You know, a lot of people use Pages as a word processor or for something very specific, like doing a newsletter. So they skip over the screen that shows you all these cool templates that you can use in Pages. I'm guilty of this myself, but when I recently wrote my book, My Pages, I had to investigate every nook and cranny in the program, and I looked at all these templates, and there's some really cool, interesting things there that it's worth knowing about. So here's the template chooser, and you can choose between word processing and page layout templates, or simply list all of them. And some really cool things if you take the time to look. For instance, let's go right into certificates. Certificates are kind of neat. There's only two of them here, but these can be kind of fun because you can select one and it will instantly create the certificate and you can fill in different things. So they can be kind of fun for families, say to give your kids an award for doing something good or give out monthly awards in the family for doing chores, doing nice things for other people. It's kind of fun to do certificates, and they've been around for a long time on computers in different print shop like applications, and it's kind of nice to know that you can print off a quick certificate in Pages. Another useful one is flyers. And you've got all sorts of different flyers, and you see they look actually a lot nicer than some of the ones you see posted around your neighborhood probably. And it's very easy to actually post different things. So for instance, if you wanted to do a for sale one, you could see that you've got a drop image here. You can just drag and drop whatever item it is you're trying to sell. And in addition to that, you've got these little tear-offs down here at the bottom with phone numbers. So you can fill them out. Now the weird thing is that because of the way Pages works, it doesn't really have the ability to just duplicate this across. So you do one and it doesn't copy the other. So all you have to do is select all inside of one of these boxes, select the next one and paste, select the next one and paste. It takes a minute. And then you can print out one of these cool flyers in color or in black and white depending on your printer and create a quick for sale or for rent or whatever poster that is easy to do. It only takes probably a minute to make one of these. Another template that's fun is under cards and imitations. You've got all these interesting little cards that you could print up, and you can see that it actually does it on two sides. Let's reduce the size here so we can see the actual card here. So it's kind of neat. So you could print it out and fold it like you want, or print it out two-sided if your printer supports that, and then actually get things on the correct sides. And you have all sorts of different card templates you can choose from. You can experiment with them and see how maybe you could use them. Now as for the rest, they're pretty much things you would expect, like for instance all these different newsletters. And you can roll over with your cursor and see the different pages in one before you open it up. And you've got brochures, for instance. And so there's really no excuse if you're going to have you know, something that requires a brochure or a newsletter for not creating at least a quick one from here. Professionally, you'll probably get a professional company or designer to create one for you. But for creating ones on a tight budget or just as a fun thing, you can certainly use these templates. So to show you how easy it is to use one of these, let's choose, for instance, a museum brochure. And let's say you just want to create a custom thing. You're doing kind of like a school exhibit or something, and you want to make it look good. If you want to change these images, it's so easy. Bring up the Media Inspector, and then you can view your photos in your iPhoto library, or you can just drag and drop from the desktop as well as drag and drop from this window. And you can put whatever images you want in these boxes. You can select any text and change the text to whatever you want. So you can very quickly go through this, change the headlines, change the text, drag and drop a bunch of images to it, and you have something that's completely customized, although it's using the same layout, which means that you can create a brochure or poster or whatever in just minutes, really, rather than actually having to come up with a design that may take hours or days. And you don't have to settle for just the templates that come with Pages. If you search the Mac App Store, you'll find out that there's a whole bunch of Pages templates sets that you can buy, and then when you buy them you're basically installing them inside of Pages so you can get a lot more. You can also search the web for ones that are available in the Mac App Store. So I hope this got you thinking a little bit about looking through the Pages templates and seeing if there's something there that you could use either for fun or for business. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now.
Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.